whispering in the trees. It's two cities and they're only...
Well, if no one else runs on the Democratic ticket against the incumbent, how can I let that stand?
You have to.
I mean, even me.
You have to.
Just for the sake of a choice. There's got to be a choice out there, some kind. Crying out loud. Never seen such a thing. Jukebox tonight at Freddy's Steakhouse. I really wanted to play the Wheel of Meat today.
Had a little taste of that last night. Jukebox played a little bit.
You left early.
Well, yeah. My stamina isn't quite what it should be yet.
I wanted to play the Wheel of Meat today. Doggone it. Let's go to, it looks like he's in the middle of the plane there in a window seat. Hey, Art.
Hey, how you doing?
Taking a beating.
Welcome back, George.
Thank you. Glad to be back.
Okay. I just wanted to say that and, glad to see your face on there. Maybe you can keep him in check.
Hey, Art.
Yes.
You called up just to tell George welcome back?
Yes, I did.
Go back over to your stool, sit down, and think of something. What is this, like, it's your funeral or something?
I know.
You ain't dead.
Not yet. I'm working on it, but
George,
it's not
welcome
yet.
Welcome back. They're going to put you right off the show.
Oh, I know.
People keep calling and wanting to talk to you. What about me? How about me? You want to run for mayor?
No.
You gonna save this city?
No, I'm running from a few things, but I'm not running for anything.
All right. Well, I'll put you on my staff. I don't care if you live in Illinois.
Well, I'll move.
Can run my campaign. You and Bill Baker.
I'll move if I have to.
Here comes another fan of George. It looks like she's strolling down the aisle. Taking a little walk. It's Gloria Lynn. Hello, Gloria. Say hello, George.
George, welcome back.
Oh, God.
Hi, darling. How are you?
I'm going to hang up on all you guys.
That old car passed admission test.
Really?
Yeah, everything. You know, there's nothing wrong but the gaskets. But welcome back. Because so many people.
You know, anytime I get to spend with the preacher is good time, Gloria.
Right.
You know,
oh, come on.
Hi, preacher. How you doing? Poor
you guys
thing.
Are ignoring me.
But I just want to, I'm so glad you're back with your buddy. But don't let your buddy kill you.
No.
Because, you know, he's a road runner.
Oh, baby.
He'll have you at every place, spinning this and all this stuff. And I heard your commercial, your voice. So you are an asset to this show.
I'll tell you what, Gloria, I've walked down the street with him and people have said hi to me that I don't even remember how I know him.
Right, because you preach, he should be just producing.
Everybody knows him.
Because
he's
got an eye
Everybody.
For that producing and, you know, and just produce to good people. Then we can get him on the Fox
News. I do know how to produce a show, there's no doubt about
Absolutely.
That.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you're a good producer. But you just got the big head.
And I like the produce department over at the Van Til's, too.
Always. But don't, preacher, don't, if you feel like it, don't forget to send me that last tape.
I think we got the, we're close to fixing the system at home where I can actually do something. We recorded a 2-minute spot yesterday at, have you read this thing, Gloria? You got to hear this.
It's funny.
The Preach Saves Christmas. I didn't do it. Someone else did it, but I had to provide a place for them to record it. And so I did. But it took us 2.5 hours to do 2 minutes because of my computer.
But you got to get it right.
I know, but it's messed up. It's messed up. I got to send it in. It's got to go back.
But you got to get things right, you know, because you don't have a continuity department down there.
No.
That's where you should be with the continuity department, because you have a gift for that.
Oh, thank you, Gloria. See? Now you're laying it on thick.
I like it.
No, just like preacher, we love you. You know what to pick out. But, George, I'm so glad you're there. We just got in the house. We haven't put you up on the computer yet. Oh, I'm on the Internet, too, preacher.
All right, we're waving.
W-W-something.
We're waving to
Max,
you.
Max so-and-so. With, featuring Roy Boy.
Oh, I thought you were watching us on the Internet.
No, I mean, I'm on there on my own. Somebody put me on their thing.
Okay, I'm going to send you a bill.
That sounds bad.
Send her a
they
bill.
Put me on the Internet.
10-4.
So have a good Christmas, all of you.
Merry
hey,
Christmas.
Remember, you're running out of Thursdays to stop at Freddy's Steakhouse this year, so you might as well pick one.
No, I'm not going to be able to make it because I can't go in there with the oxygen.
Oh, okay. Yep.
You know, and blow up the place.
A lot of people.
You know, not unless they give me enough money then I might go and I can leave that to Erica. Then the Democrats will take the tax from them.
You got that right.
So have a good day.
Thanks, Gloria. It's always nice to hear from Gloria. Let's go in the middle. Who's in the middle of the
continuity? I had an aunt that took pills for that continuity stuff.
Hey, it's Stinky Dan.
Hey, long life, preacher. Hi, George. How you doing?
Hey, Stinks. What's going on, man?
Oh, man. I got one question for you. Does Poligo still own the restaurant on Torrance Avenue?
The family does.
The family does?
Yeah, I'm
okay,
pretty sure that Jerry's retired.
Hey, now, I seen a weird car, George. I just got to tell you about it. It was a car where you open the front end of the car to get in it, and you take the steering wheel, and you got to put that back to get inside the car.
Oh, that's a new one.
No, that's an old one.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Because I saw one the other day, some electric car that has that.
Yeah, but this is an old one, and it was they're going to repurpose it. And,
wow.
And the whole front end comes up. And then the steering wheel has to go out of the car kind of to get in.
What the hell is Stinky talking about? Stinky! what are you talking about?
It's a weird-looking car.
Whatever
they're going to repurpose
smoking,
it.
I'll have some.
What's going on, Stinky?
Name of it right now, but it's a weird-looking car.
I heard you're going to Chinatown.
I forgot to pick up those darn eggs for you.
A couple of Stinky eggs. What six Stinky eggs run you, anyway?
About $1.65 or six.
Six is plenty.
Stinky, they should be paying you. All right.
We don't need any more than that.
Let's see what Earl the Pearl, he wants to walk around and use the laboratory, apparently. Hey, Earl.
Hey, Breach, how you doing? George, how you doing?
What's happening,
I think
Earl?
The car the gentleman's talking about is the old Isetta.
Yeah.
It was made by BMW, and the German car, the Messerschmitt, which I think might have been made by Audi.
I wasn't late because Audie made the airplane, too.
Yep.
George, you ever worked on a plane?
No. No.
See what you can do with this one.
I went on a couple of dates on an airplane once. I do some of my best work on a plane, but I've
really?
Never worked on a plane.
Jeez.
So how you been doing, George?
Okay, buddy.
All right, my friend. You guys have a good show. Take care and talk to you guys later.
Thanks, Earl.
Thanks, Earl. Now, listen, I'm putting my foot down here. We're not going to call up every 10 seconds and ask George how he's doing. George, make your statement. How you doing?
I'm doing just fine.
All right. I mean, because I can barely keep, what do we got, 53 people aboard? I'm not going to keep 53 people on this plane with everybody asking you how you're doing.
No. If you're
How are you doing, George?
I'm fine. Especially
All right.
if you're going to feed them those Brussels sprouts.
Crying out loud.
You don't want 53 people eating Brussels sprouts on your plane.
No, it's baked beans.
Well, that's even worse.